Hi there. My name's Ian Rance. What comes to mind when you think of a one-man band? Is it that like century-old image of the guy with the kazoo and the cymbals between his knees and the drum on his back? If it is, it's time to think again. See, the Twin Cities has a vibrant one-man band community. So much so, I woke up one day not too long ago realizing I knew three of them, which isn't bad for a guy who's never met someone named Jerry. Inspired, I decided to document their story. Naively, I decided to do it all alone. Yes, this is a documentary entirely shot, edited, everything by me. There are no camera people, there are no sound guys. Here, let me just prove this to you. See, look, it's just me, alone, in a desolate part of town, with expensive cameras. I hadn't really thought about that part until right now, so we'll make this quick. The first person we're profiling is Ray Evangelista. Ray has been holding down Thursday nights at the Hunan Garden in downtown St. Paul for over 20 years. He soothes a sometimes angsty crowd with great 60s and 70s funk hits, hits of today, and a little bit of Santana. You've got to have Santana. So get ready to watch it. This is the first installment of One Man. Enjoy.
My name is Ray Evangelista. Originally from the Philippines.
How long have you been a one-man band?
At the Hunan, it's almost 20 years now.
Beforehand, how did you become a one-man band?
I decided to do it when this disco era came, and we used to play 6-7 nights, and all of a sudden the club owner said, well guys, we're gonna have just Friday and Saturday. A lot of people will say, why don't you go solo? You know, just you and your guitar. And I said, let me think about it. Yeah, because, you know, I don't know if I could do it, you know. Mm. But all of a sudden, I decided, I think I can do it. I can do it. And then I got the background tracks, and it's more better because I can play my lead. And all of a sudden, these people will say, wow, you sound good, you know. I don't have to worry about other members, because sometimes they say, oh man, I'm sick, I can't play. So one man band, as long as I got my CD or my my music, I can play anywhere I want. I can, you know, it's just freedom. Yeah.
But that means that you're entirely reliant on technology. Have you ever had the backing system crash out on you before?
Yes.
How do you recover from that?
I used to use computer, and all of a sudden I'm playing, and all of a sudden it's just computer just died, and then they were dancing, and all of a sudden, oh my God, this is a disaster, oh my God. So a lot of people just stop and look at me, and I said, sorry guys. And like when I play Santana, they're so amazed. Well, sounds like Santana, but I said, well, it's the guitar and the percussion, everything is like a whole band, you know. know. And I said, well, that's how it is. It's like a one-man band, but it's a full sound.
How did you, 20 years ago, find the Houdin?
It's just a trial. I know the guy, the bartender, he's a Filipino guy, and I asked him, I said, maybe we can try it. And he said, wow, I don't know, man, it's a Chinese restaurant. You know, I don't know if it's gonna work. You're singing, English, and this is Chinese. But we tried, and lots of people come, and they said, wow, I can't believe there's a Chinese restaurant. They got live bands. When I play at Houdin, I have to play like a lot of R&B, soul music, because Santana, everybody loves Santana, but I don't know if I can play maybe a little country, but you can't. it depends on the crowd, but lots of Marvin Gaye, Kool & the Gang, all those old school.
But you sometimes play originals, right?
Oh, that's right, originals, yeah. People sometimes, they said, oh man, I love that song. And then all of a sudden I said, that's one of my original songs. I said, wow. Sounds like Santana. Because, I got that, he's my idol.
No, let's actually go way back. So you're from Guam. Was American rock and roll very popular there?
We got the when we played there. It's like the 70s. They got all kinds of like Deep Purple, Black Sabbath, and all those heavy metal. That's what I play because at the USO tour. We play at the EM Club, and that's all they want to hear.
So you were playing on basses?
Yes, with the USO. Sabanas.
What's that mean?
It calls the mountain Sabanas. It's a Spanish thing. That's 78. We play a lot of disco, like Bee Gees. it's a different era.
And how'd you guys pick Minnesota?
A guy from here, a manager, said there's opening at Pearl Diver. So,
The Pearl Diver
in Minnetonka.
Aloha, my friends. Come with me to a lush tropical island. Come with me to the Pearl Diver in Minnetonka. The Pearl Diver, a Polynesian restaurant filled with the romance and splendor of the South Seas. Giant tiki gods, beautiful carvings, unusual tropical lights. Enjoy exotic rum cocktails or any of the more than 40 entrees and dinners on the menu. The Pearl Diver, west of Ridgedale on Highway 12 in Minnetonka.
I think it's gone now, but He said, guys, there's opening for a month. Maybe you guys can come . So we came here and my God, this was cold, but we played for a month and then they said, you guys, you wanna play some more? Like maybe 3 more months? And we decided, okay, we stay, And then we found O'Brien agency just say, guys, you wanna play and like the Holiday Inn or Ramada Inn, and I'll book you guys, and that's how we start. I said, okay, maybe stay here in Minnesota. When I first got here, it's like, you guys are smoking or something. I said, what? You know, we were playing.
Yeah.
It's like, you guys smoking, man. You know, like, hey, man, we are smoking, what? I said, no, this is, you know, we know the slang words yet. You know, we just got, and then one time when we play somewhere, you guys are bad. It's like, man, we're bad. And then the guy said, our manager said, no, bad is good. Oh, okay. So we learn a lot. We learn a lot, man.
You never went back, right?
Never went back, no.
Even though it was really cold.
Even it's cold. Sounds like sax.
So let's go through the tracks on this. So what do we have? So what tracks do we have playing right now?
Here's the drums right here.
Okay, and you did those?
Yeah.
You did that through your drum pads?
Yeah. Here's the string.
And then you did through the guitar.
Guitar.
And then you got bass.
The bass.
And how'd you do the bass? Did you do the bass through the keyboard?
I did, right here in this keyboard right here.
And as you said, this took probably about 2 hours?
About 2 hours, yeah.
Okay.
Looking at your eyes, kind of heaven eyes. Usually the drums will be right up here, because, you know, like when you record a regular like a band, the drums will be right here, the vocal will be here. So one man band gotta be, the drums will be up here, so it's a different mix.
Okay.
With
for you to sing over later.
yeah. So this is what I do.
And then you take a good mix out and then you record it.
And record it right in the mini disc.
Okay.
How many songs do you have in your arsenal?
Right now I got 600. You know, I got more than that, but some are just, I don't play no more.
Songs in there that
you
just as soon never do.
You mean the?
Yeah, your personal tastes. You know, it's like you just as soon not play that song.
Yeah, it's yeah. I know my taste, and I said, no, I'm not gonna play it no more.
Like what? Like what songs have you pulled out because of that?
Like Bee Gees.
Really?
You know, it's like when I play the Bee Gees, I said. We got regular customer there that the moment I see their face, I said, okay, this is the song that they like, you know. That's why they come back, because of the, you know, I know their faces and I know their songs. And I changed some of the music, when I play Earth, Wind & Fire, they love it. then I changed to Santana, and then I changed to R&B, and that's how they love it, because I mix it up. Just make it all good. Let's name the town. We'll shut it down. When it's like one guy, like his name is Amos, he comes in, I know his song, and all of a sudden, he don't have to request the song. I just play it, and they said, wow, I'm special. The night's gonna be a good night. The night's gonna be a good night. But the night's gonna be a good, good night. But the night's gonna be a good night. But the night's gonna be a good night. But the night's gonna be a good, good night. I mean, if the band's, you know, you're playing took up more of your time, would you ever give up your Thursday night gig at the Who now?
No, I don't think so. I love that gig, man.
So, and when what is it that's kept you around for 20 years? What is it that's kept you interested in playing?
It gives me I don't know. It's I get lots of energy when I play at the Hunan. It's like it's like a therapy for me. You know, it's a good feeling that every Thursday I'm there.
And so you've been doing it for 20 years. How much longer do you want to do it?
I think I'm gonna do it until I die.
And how long is that gonna be?
Thank you. All right. Need a glass?